Assalamu alaikum students, today we will learn about operating system, but before that we will recall what we have learned in chapter number 1. In chapter number 1, that is Know Your Computer, we have covered topics such as early calculating devices. In early calculating devices, we have three main early calculating devices. First one is Abacus, second one is Napier-Bond, and third one is Pascaline. Next we have learned evolution of computers. In evolution of computers, we have learned five generations of computer. First generation of computer is vacuum based. Second generation computer is transistor based computers. Third generation computer is integrated circuit based computers. Fourth one is microprocessor computers. And fifth one is artificial intelligence. After that, next topic is classification of computers. In classification of computers, we have learned four basic classifications of computer. First one is microcomputer, mini computer, mainframe computers, and supercomputers. In functional components of a computer, we have learned some basic input devices, central processing device, and some basic output devices. As you know, computer memory is of two types, primary memory and secondary memory. In primary memory, we have RAM and ROM, and in secondary memory, we have different storage devices. Last topic of chapter number 1 is categorization of software. In that, we have three types of software: system software, then we have application software, and last one is utility software. Second chapter is about operating system, but before that we will see the definition of operating system and its meaning. As we know that an operating system is a system software which is necessary for the computer to work. It works like a manager which manages all tasks. You have seen that when we switch on computer or mobile, it took some time to load your home screen, but basically happened is your device is starting the operating system in the background. This software help you control your computer and run other applications on top of it. Basically, operating system is a computer program that act as an interface, path or bridge between hardware and computer user. Computer structure consists of four components. As you can see in this flowchart, we have four components: user, application software, operating system and hardware. The hardware are the physical parts of the computer such as input devices, output devices, CPU that is attached to the computer. On top of operating hardware, we have operating system. Operating system is the boss, or you can imagine operating system as a person that act as a translator between the hardware of the computer and the operating system. Then we have application software. In application software, it is a program that help and provide services to the user. Some basic application softwares that we use are MS Office, some compilers, web browsers, video games and database system. Next we have some tasks that is provided by the operating system to the computer to perform the task. Some input that we give to the computer, the operating system then process it through processing device such as CPU and show us the output on the screen with the help of output devices. It keep tracks of the files and directories that we save and work on the computer on the disk. Then we have it control all the peripheral devices attached to the computer. What are the peripheral devices? They are the physical devices such as keyboard, mouse, printer attached to the computer. Next is it act as a bridge or interface between the computer user and the hardware. Now we will do reading from the book and see what it is written in your book about system software. Open page number 16 and read with me. Operating system. Computer cannot function on their own. They require programming instructions to work and manage the system. This job is done by an operating system. Now you can underline the definition of operating system. An operating system is a system software. It may be regarded as the backbone of computer and it is an intermediary between user and the computer. It performs the basic tasks of a computer. These are given below. What basic tasks it performs? it perform. First one is recognize input from the keyboard. When the user input something from the keyboard, it recognize that. Second one is it send output to the display screen. When the output is displayed by the operating processing device such as CPU, it is displayed on the display screen such as monitor. Third one is it keep track of files and directories on the disk. All the files that you store and work on directories is saved by the operating system. Third one is it control the peripheral devices. All the devices that you attach, input and output devices, all the peripheral devices means physical devices that you attach, is managed by the operating system. Then fifth one is it act as an interface. Interface means it provide a path or a bridge between hardware of a computer and the user. Some of the commonly used operating systems are disk operating system, that is called DOS, then MS Windows, Linux, Windows, NT and Mac. Windows is the most commonly used operating system. Now we will recall what is an operating system. Software is a set of program that runs a computer system. It not only manages hardware, user and a bridge between the two. Then computer system is stored and executed with the help of computer hardware. Definition of operating system, it is an interface or path between a computer hardware and user. So chapter number 2, second chapter and third topic is operating system.